Hello students, today we will discuss planning and design of green building, right? So today's topic is building system design, how a building is designed in a systematic way, right? So I've made a template on which one side we have goals, which we can see here, and the other side are strategies, right? So first of all, I would like to discuss about the energy related to the design system of a building, right? So on this energy designs, the goal is design and select all building systems to meet energy targets. We mentioned certain targets regarding the energy. So what are the strategies based on this? Strategies are mentioned here, right? Conduct an energy simulation. The energy simulation provides the energy and cost information required to make the best selection of building system, right? So these are the strategies which we can learn from this template, right? The goal is to investigate energy and the cost saving resulting from the synergy between the various building systems and their components. So basically the aim is to reduce the energy, ultimately the reduction in the cost. Right. Once the energy load are optimized through the selection, the best combination of structures and envelope ventilations, water and lighting systems, the design team will select the most appropriate mechanical systems to meet this load. Right. So this process will generally lead to selection of smaller mechanical systems than would normally be in the case. Right. So the second goal is to choose the environmentally sensitive structural material. So based on this goal, we have strategies like design with salvage, recycle and efficient material. Well, we should use the recycles or scrap material which can be used again in the designing of the green building, right? So based on this, we have certain specifications which were mentioned later or the upcoming slides, right? So use locally harvested or manufacturing materials. This will reduce the environmental impact on transportation, using the material with low environmental impact over their life, right? These are few softwares which you can use here, right? And now further, the another goal is design envelope to reduce heating, cooling, lighting and ventilation of flow. Means in the conventional buildings, we need ACs to cool down the structure, or we need heaters to heat up on the different environment. So this goal basically deals with the proper or the best design so that the reduction would be there in the cost of heating, cooling, lighting and ventilation, etc. So based on this goal, we have certain strategies which should be seen by the engineer to design a green building. So the design strategies are mentioned over here. We can see. So first strategy is design an energy efficient envelope, right? Appropriate insulation, light construction and high performance, low E windows, etc. To avoid thermal bridging in the walls, right? Continuous installation of aluminate metal studs in outside walls or otherwise ensure thermal breaks, and optimizing solar heat gain and reduce glare. The design option includes selection, glazing, appropriate ratio of visible light transmittance to solar heat gain coefficient, etc. So these are basically few strategies which can look for these goals, which we can use to accomplish these goals. Okay, right. And the next slide, we have another goal is the use of passive and active renewable energies, right? Like we should use such materials which can be recycled or reused, right? So based on this goal, we have certain strategies like design building for solar heat and light. We could use solar heating devices, right? Solar heat gain and glare. So these are the strategies which can be seen. Like the design building to incorporate the site wind and air, right? We should construct or build a building such that natural light or natural air ventilation should be there, so there would be a reduction in the cost of air conditioning or heating the adverse climates, right? Assess the feasibility of incorporating renewable energy. So we should use the renewable energies like passive solar technique, solar wall, active solar technologies like photovoltaic panels. So another goal is to optimize indoor quality equality environment, sorry, optimize indoor environmental quality, right? So based on this goal, we have two strategies: optimize daylight end use and the design envelope to provide adequate fresh air, right? Another is ventilation design. They should be there. So excess ventilation requirement. So the strategy is to set ventilation target. The first step is the ventilation target is for the team to set up optimum CMF targets, right? And the third goal is to reduce the ventilation load, right? Like exhaust and exhaust, they should be reduced in the designing or in the construction of the building, right? We should not provide such things for the ventilation. It should be natural, right? So strategy based on it is selection of efficient mechanical or natural ventilation system. We should provide a natural ventilation system in spite of providing the mechanical ventilation devices. So ultimately, the cost will be reduced, right? So access the potential for heat recovery system should be used. Consider using zones. We have different zones. Weigh the benefits, right? Reduce the system load, right? Provide user control, right? We are not using conventional heat to cover the construction of the building. So we also look after the comfort, right? And if you like that, it is out of control or we cannot control the construction of the building, right? So this goal is the most important one. So based on this, provide individual control for ventilation, operable windows in addition to individual control for airflow and the users to turn off and also allow